Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today our lecture is data flow diagram. Last time we have discussed few things about data flow diagram, that what is data flow diagram, which symbols are used in data flow diagram, what is the difference between DFT and flow chart, and few other things, right? DFT is basically graphical representation of the data flowing from one component to another in your system, right? How data is flowing from one component to another, and from where to where your data is flowing from one component to another, data flow diagram show it, right? It is simply a graphical representation of showing the data flow between components. Today we will discuss about different DFT levels, that how many levels of DFT are over there, right? And how we will draw the DFT diagram. Then we will discuss about applications of DFT and the conclusion, right? There are three levels of DFT: level 0 DFT, level 1 DFT, and level 2 DFT. Level 0 DFT is also called context diagram. It's another name is that it is also called context diagram. And what is level 0 DFT? Level 0 DFT is the most simple DFT. It just show you the whole system, right? That data is flowing from this there to there. That's it. It does not tell you about the particular minute details of your system, that one is subsystem and then the data will go here and there and there. No, it just shortly tell you about the whole system. And in level 0 DFT, there is emphasis on external entities, that how your system is interacting with external entities, like your system or your actors. Level 0 DFT example. For example, in this figure, it is an example of level 0 DFT. Very simple diagram, just showing the relationship of two entities, just showing the relationship of two components, you can say, right? What is this? This is external entity, because we have discussed in our last lecture that the rectangle represent external entity. And what is this? We have discussed in our last lecture that oval shape represent process, right? So this is your process, this is your external entity, right? What is this? Again, this is your external entity, right? Okay, ye to hume pata chal gaya. So what is this? What admin is connected with hospital management system, and then hospital management system is also connected with patient. There are no further details that what is the process, whole process going on, what is, how admin is related to them, how patient will connect them, contact them, right? There is simple description over here that there is some kind of hospital management system, that is our whole process, right? And admin, there is an admin of that hospital, obviously, right, who is managing all the things in the hospital. And we also know that there are few patients who are coming to that hospital, and they are also linked with that hospital management system. So there is a relation, there is a data that is flowing from admin to admin in hospital management system, and there is also some kind of data that is flowing from patient, right? Means there is a simple relationship is showing that there are two external entities, admin and patient. How admin will interact in the hospital management system, with the hospital management system, what is the role of admin in hospital management system, and then what is the role of patient in hospital management system, and how patient will interact with the hospital management system, right? Simply this diagram is showing it. Next level is level 1 DFT. Level 1 DFT is a bit high form of DFT means it tell you about few more details than level 0. Level 1 tell us about different basic modules of the system, that what are the external entities, then what are the process and how data is stored and where is data stored, right? And how we will get data from one entity, right? From one component. So level 1 is describing the basic modules of the system, that what, where data is stored, what are the external entities, what is the process behind that, how data is flowing between all these components, right? So this all is showing in level 1 DFT. For example, okay, now I will explain you this figure. This is an example of level 1 DFT. Now there is a few more description of components here. External entities are here, right? Then processes are there, right? And different data stores are also here, right? So it is more detailed figure than level 0 DFT. It is better than level 0 DFT. Okay. First of all, look at the symbols here. What is this symbol? This one in which voter is written. This is data store. I have told you that this was the symbol for data store. You can write the just two lines for data store, like over here, that voter is your data store. Like voter is someone like which who the person who will vote, and then you will get results. Another entity is here is voter. This one is external entity. Here voter is acting as external entity, right? I will tell you example, then you will be more clear about it. What is this login? This is process, because it is written in oval shape. That, and you also know generally that login is a process. Then next is voting. Voting is also a process. Then result. Results are also a process, that results are being compiled and then shown, right? What is this? This is again data stored, that candidate key information yaha store. Then vote update. Vote update bhi kahan hoga? Kisi database mein hoga. And then again, this one is your data store. Clear? Okay, now symbols are clear to you. Look at here that what is happening actually. Basically, this is the figure that voter will poll its vote, right? Voter poll karega vote, theek hai. Candidate ki information uske paas show ho rahi hogi. Login karke apne system se, wo us information ki base pe apne jo bhi uska candidate, jis candidate ko bhi usne vote dena hai, wo usko vote dega. ठीक है, एज अ रिजल्ट आपके डेटाबेस में वोट अपडेट हो जाएगा, और फिर ये प्रोसेस कंटिन्यू रहेगा सारे वोटर्स के लिए. एट द एंड क्या होगा कि जितने वोट्स अपडेट हुए होंगे वो सारे काउंट होंगे, राइट? काउंटेड वोट्स की बेस पे रिजल्ट कंपाइल होगा, और रिजल्ट कंपाइल्ड अगेन वो वोटर को शो हो जाएगा. क्लियर? लुक एट हियर. Here, the voter, on the basis of info of voter, right, means you have compiled an online election system in which there is an information related to voter on the portal or on that system. On the basis of that info, voter will log in into the system, right, by using username and password. Okay, by using username and password, voter will log in into the system. Voter can also check the status from the system. Clear? दिस एरो इज डाउनवर्ड मीन्स यूजर नेम एंड पासवर्ड के थ्रू वोटर लॉग इन होगा. दिस एरो इज अपवर्ड मीन्स ये होल सिस्टम वोटर देख भी सकता है. वोटर कैन सी द स्टेटस राइट. अब लॉग इन कर लिया उसने वोटर ने, ठीक है. अब अगर वो वोटर वहाँ रजिस्टर है सिस्टम पर तो ऑथेंटिकेट हो जाएगा और वो वोट कर सकता है कास्ट. लेकिन अगर वो नहीं है रजिस्टर्ड तो फिर वो आगे मजीद प्रोसेस कंटिन्यू नहीं हो सकेगा, ठीक है. नाउ वोटर इज रजिस्टर्ड राइट. नाउ इफ द वोटर वांट टू वोट इट्स कैंडिडेट हाउ इट विल वोट हाउ ही विल वोट. द कैंडिडेट इंफॉर्मेशन इज आल्सो प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर इन द सिस्टम ऑन द स्क्रीन राइट फ्रॉम द डेटाबेस. दिस इज योर डेटा स्टोर वेयर कैंडिडेट इंफॉर्मेशन इज प्लेस्ड एंड फ्रॉम हियर द वोटर विल टेक कैंडिडेट्स इंफॉर्मेशन एंड इट विल वोट. क्लियर. अब वोट पोल कर लिया वोटर ने, अब क्या होगा यहाँ से वोट पोल हुआ तो अब वोट अपडेट होगा डेटाबेस में. वोट अपडेट होगा कि एक मजीद वोटर ने आपको वोट कास्ट कर दिया है, ठीक है. वोट विल बी अपडेटेड ओवर हियर इन डेटाबेस. इट मींस अगेन इट इज योर डेटा स्टोर दैट योर वोट्स विल बी स्टोर्ड ओवर हियर. हियर कैंडिडेट इंफॉर्मेशन वाज देयर दैट इज व्हाई दिस वाज डेटा स्टोर. हियर वोटर इंफॉर्मेशन वाज देयर दैट इज व्हाई इट वाज डेटा स्टोर. हियर द अपडेटेड वोट्स आर स्टोर्ड देयरफॉर इट इज डेटा स्टोर. So, votes are updated. Now, all the updated votes will be counted automatically by automatically in the system, right? And on the basis of those counted votes, your result will be compiled, right? And then this result will be shown to the voter. Now, voter can see the result that this much vote this candidate takes. कि मतलब उसे पता चले कि जिस कैंडिडेट को मैंने वोट दिया था उसने कितने वोट्स लिए, राइट. दिस इज हाउ योर ऑनलाइन इलेक्शन सिस्टम विल वर्क. सो दिस इज अ डीएफटी लेवल 1 डीएफटी फॉर ऑनलाइन इलेक्शन सिस्टम दैट हाउ वोटर विल वोट फॉर द कैंडिडेट. द कैंडिडेट इंफॉर्मेशन इज देयर. द वोटर इज ऑलरेडी रजिस्टर्ड ऑन द सिस्टम. वोटर विल लॉग इन देन वोटर विल वोट द कैंडिडेट एंड votes will be updated and results will also be declared on the same system and that result will be seen from by the voter. Voter can see that result. Clear. Next is level 2 DFT. Level 2 DFT is a bit better than level 1 and level 0 DFT. It will tell you about more details about the system, right. It will tell you few more details. It is more descriptive, right. For example, here this diagram is telling you that how a passenger will know about driver. If a passenger needs taxi, how it will look get that taxi. For example, suppose this one is diagram for cream app, right? Cream हो जाए या अबर हो जाए, कोई भी suppose कर लें, ठीक है. If passenger is over here, right? This one is external entity. Passenger is external entity. Driver is external entity. Finding nearby taxi, this is the process. Listing driver's location, this is a process. Google map, it contains some information. This is kind of database. This is data store. Taxi record, again, some data is stored over here. So this is data store. Now, data is flowing from between different components through arrows, right? With the help of arrows, data is flowing. That, okay. Passenger is here. Passenger's location की base पे passenger locate कर trace कर लेगा. वो find out करेगा nearby taxi को. अब nearby taxi को कैसे find out करेगा? पहले taxi की location, driver की सारी जितनी भी locations की list है उसमें से उसे रिसीव हो जाएगी, ठीक है, उससे उसे पता चलेगा कि अच्छा नियर बाय टैक्सी कौन सी है, फिर नियर बाय टैक्सी है कितनी दूर, है कहाँ, उसका ड्राइवर कौन है, वो टैक्सी किस कलर की है, टैक्सी का कंडीशन कैसी है, टैक्सी का मॉडल कौन सा है, या चलें गाड़ी कह लें तो गाड़ी का मॉडल कौन सा है, ठीक है, वो सारी इंफॉर्मेशन यहाँ से उसे रिसीव हो जाएगी, ठीक है, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट पैसेंजर को करीब से टैक्सी मिल जाएगी, ठीक है। यहाँ पर क्या होगा, ड्राइवर की लोकेशन भी उसे नो हो उसे पता चल जाएगी, गूगल मैप के थ्रू उसे लोकेशन भी पता चल जाएगी कि ड्राइवर है कहाँ पर, जो सबसे करीब टैक्सी है वो है कहाँ पर, ठीक है, एंड देन टैक्सी के रिकॉर्ड से उससे टैक्सी की सारी डिटेल्स भी पता चल जाएंगी कि व्हाट इज़ द नंबर ऑफ नंबर प्लेट ऑफ टैक्सी, और व्हाट इज़ द कलर ऑफ टैक्सी, एंड देन हु इज़ द ड्राइवर ऑफ टैक्सी, ठीक है, ऑल द डिटेल्स अबाउट टैक्सी एंड अबाउट द ड्राइवर एंड वेयर इज दैट टैक्सी, हाउ मच एट हाउ मच डिस्टेंस इट इज राइट नाउ, राइट राइट, सो ऑल द डिटेल्स पैसेंजर विल रिसीव, ओके। सो दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ यूर लेवल टू डी एफ टी। In this example, in very detail, your system is described in very detail. Every minute detail is shown over here. The driver, Google Map, taxi list, everything is mentioned over arrow, right? That how data is flowing from one component to another. So level 2 DFT is more better, right? You got this example? I hope you got it. So these were three different levels of DFT, level 0, level 1 and level 2. Next is applications of DFT. DFT are used in your software development, right, in software engineering field. DFTs are also used in by business analyst, right, business analyst also use DFT to know about the processes, that how the processes will work in their organizations, right? So they by the help of DFT, it become easier for them to identify the risks and all the processes, and then profit loss and everything, every minute detail of the process, right? So it is easier for business minded people and the head of organizations to analyze their organization, to analyze their work by the help of DFT. Another application of DFT is in re-engineering. Re-engineering is sort of re-engineer something. The DFT play an important role in that field also. Then next application of DFT is system structure. That how you will know about your whole structure of system, DFT will tell you about easily, right? That's all. So we have completed our topic of DFT. Class, what is DFT? DFT is the graphical representation of flow of data from one component to another in any system, right? And we have discussed three levels of DFT, level 0, level 1 and level 2, that how they differ from each other and which one is better, right? And DFT, as we have discussed earlier, that it is a very good communication tool between user and system designer, right? And DFT gives you a very best description of your system, right? It gives you a very accurate, very very high level system overview, right? Okay, that's all. And it is easy to understand the system by technical people and non-technical people also by the help of DFT. Only DFT make it easier for the non-technical people to understand the system. Clear? So these are all the benefits of using DFT. That's all. I hope you got it, class.